Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see, so what's wrong with it?
Good morning, Garnets. My name is Kamaya.
And I'm Aiden, and you're watching Garnet News, your regular source of school events and happenings.
First, we have Jeremiah's inspiration of the day.
Hi, I'm Jeremiah, here to give you this week's inspiration.
Was it motivation?
Motispiration. As the school year draws ever closer to its end, most people are now preparing for things to happen in the summer, such like going on vacations, seeing people they haven't seen in a while, go to college, find a job, or stay in the room and play video games until it's all over. With that said, in most cases, these things require a little bit of a certain thing, a certain word, known as planning. That's right, planning. This week, why don't you decide to try and do a little bit of planning if you aren't already doing that? Get something like a planning book. Perhaps use a calendar on your phone, on a wall. Use timers or alarms that remind you of things. Leave notes for yourself and always plan ahead so you have plenty of time in case anything changes. So again, this week, start planning something out and hopefully all will go well. I'm Jeremiah and this is this week's inspiration. Motispiration. Yeah.
We go to Aiden Sermon to look at his review of the TV show The Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Aiden Sermon?
Hey Garnets, it's me, Aiden Sermon, and today we're taking a look at the pretty popular TV show that just ended, Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Now, at the end of this review, if you are interested in watching the show, I definitely recommend that you actually see the movie Captain America and the Civil War before this, because there are a lot of characters that are in that are also in the show. So the main characters in the show are Sam, who's also known as the Falcon, Bucky, who's also known as the Winter Soldier. We also have a new Captain America, and Zemo is also in this show, who is he's a character from Captain America in the Civil War. So in the beginning of the show, we have a pretty easy to follow storyline with a clear and main antagonist. However, the story will definitely get more complex in the later episodes. But just to give you a quick summary, we follow Bucky and Sam as they investigate and try to stop this terrorist organization called the Flag Smashers, who are led by Carly Morgenthau. Now, this organization is very physically strong as they have access to Super Soldier Serum, which, to remind you, is the serum that made Captain America so strong. Now, their goal is to try to make the world how it was before the blip occurred, so when half the human population was dusted. Now, of course, just like any other show, there are many other antagonists. However, that's the only one I'll give you for the time being. So how do I rate this show? I'd say it has a few weak points, but overall, a very exciting plot to follow and a lot of action-packed scenes.
Well, do you like softball? Hitting that ball? Here's Julia with the softball report.
On April 27th, the softball team beat Haddonfield 10-3. On April 29th, they won their game against Haddon Township 6-3. And on April 30th, they won their game against Cinnaminston 8-0. Let's take a look.
Today we played Haddonfield and we ended up winning 10-0. Our sophomore here, Maddie Clark, hit her first home run of the season.
We had a tough loss yesterday. We had a lot of key hits today that really helped us bounce back.
Woo! Go Garnets!
Victoria has been cooking this week. Let's go check out what she has made.
Hey Garnets, it's Victoria. Today we're cooking. Today's recipe is shrimp fried rice with soy sauce chicken. Here are all the ingredients I use. Alrighty, so first you start off boiling water in a large pot for your rice. Once the water is to a rolling boil, add salt, and then pour your rice into the pot. Stir it a bit and even it out and put a lid on it and let it cook. While the rice cooks, cook your shrimp. Put your shrimp in a large pan and cook it using oil. Make sure your shrimp is seasoned with pepper or whatever seasoning you use for shrimp. Cook your shrimp until it is a golden brown color. Set it to the side and prep your chicken. I season my chicken with garlic powder and pepper. I cut them into 1-inch chunks or smaller and toss them into a separate pan. Cook your chicken and make sure it is cooked all the way through. While it is still cooking, pour some low-sodium soy sauce into the pan and make sure the chicken is fully covered. Now check to see if your rice is ready. It should be soft and not too sticky. To start the rice, crack an egg and beat it till scrambled. Transfer some rice into the large pan with the shrimp in it. Turn the stove on and pour the egg on top and immediately start mixing. Add soy sauce, grounded pepper, a few drops of sesame seed oil, a bit of ginger paste, and mix it all together. Let it cook while mixing, then transfer it onto a dish with the chicken. Then voila, your shrimp fried rice and soy sauce chicken is complete. Let me tell you, this tasted so good. Big thanks to Brianne for helping me out.
Took a look at the boys' tennis team. I asked Captain Ryan Mortenberg how their season has been going. Let's check that out.
So right now we're undefeated, thankfully, and I think a big part of that is we would come out and practice a lot together during the winter, which is really helpful for our squad to get a little bit ahead of each team because we've been 3-2-ing a couple teams. And honestly, I feel like that's the best part about our team is that everyone wants to learn, wants to get better as much as they can, as fast as they can, and I hope we keep the good vibes rolling.
Alright, I'm back with the music news. You know what we're doing. Same thing as usual. Done this a few times now. Getting into the roll of things. Let's go. So, DJ Khaled dropped an album, Khaled, which is his real life name. A few good songs, some of the key tracks being one with Justin Bieber and 21 Savage. One of the worst ones is the one with Cardi B, Big Paper. That was hated by TikTok already, just barely into the cycle of things. On Me with Megan Thee Stallion, which is a really unexpected feature. So Megan Thee Stallion is basically getting the Gunna effect being put on her, and if you don't know what the Gunna effect is, in around 2017, 2018, Gunna was on pretty much every song as a feature, and you would see him pretty much everywhere. In 2019, it was DaBaby. In 2020, 2021, it was DaBaby and Megan Thee Stallion and Lil Baby, and you just see them on literally every single song possible. There's not as many albums or tracks that came out this past week as weeks before, especially in the rap game. It's pretty stale still. 5 months into 2020, nothing really stood out so far. So that's pretty much it, and I guess on to the next one.
Daniel has a report on the FCA Club. Daniel?
Mr. Johnson and Mr. Nguyen would love to inform you that the FCA Club will be starting up again. The first meeting will be on Wednesday, May 12th, 7:30 a.m. at room 104. The meeting will give everyone the opportunity to share their love of God and what He means in your life. Everyone is welcome. Be on the lookout for a reminder and a Google Meet code. Hope to see you there.
Hello, I'm Daniel from Garnet Live. I'm here with Mr. Johnson and Mr. Nguyen, and they're going to tell me about the FCA Club. So, what do you do in this club and what does it entail?
FCA is Fellowship of Christian Athletes, and we're going to meet for the first time on Wednesday, the 12th of May, which is should be a couple days after this airs. And I think from our perspective, we just want to share how important God is in our lives with you guys, and we want to give other Christians an opportunity to come help us grow together. It's a time of Bible study and fellowship, and we really look forward to seeing as many that can make it. We're going to meet at 7:30, room 104.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. See you there.
Yeah, hope to see you guys.
See you.
You know you like meditation? Yeah, you know you like meditation. Check out Amara with the Yoga Club.
Hey, y'all. It's Amara coming at you from the library. and I will be talking about yoga for this segment. Ran by Ms. Lubar and Mrs. Rooney. So, yoga club is a place where students of all experiences come together for some mindful movement. They start each meeting with a short journaling session and share if that's a vibe. Then they set an intention, do some yoga, and check back in with ourselves and each other. It's a great way to end the school day in a supportive and uplifting community.
That's all for this installment in this week's Granite News. Thanks for tuning in.
We'll see you again next week. And as always,
go Garnets!
Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play.